We're looking at some health headlines this morning with our Morning News medical contributor and Northwestern Medicine physician, Dr. Lauren Streicher. Thanks for being with us.
Hello.
Good morning.
All right, first up, alcohol for people under 40.
Yeah. All right, we know that a lot of alcohol is bad, but the question is when does it turn bad? How much is okay to drink? So to answer that question, there's a huge study that's going on that's funded by the Gates Foundation, and this is the Global Burden of Disease Study that is worldwide and is studying millions of people, and they're now in their 30th year. And they specifically were looking at the alcohol under 40 because it turns out that that is the number one risk factor associated with death in young men. So this is what they found, and nobody's going to like this. But what they found is that teeny amounts of alcohol are associated with bad health outcomes. So we are talking 2 teaspoons of wine a day, 2.5 tablespoons of beer a day, and they start to see those negative effects. So you get a sip, that's pretty much it. But on the flip side, interestingly, they found over the age of 40 that actually there was some benefit to small amounts of alcohol. We're looking at 2 glasses of wine a day was associated with a decreased risk of cardiovascular disease and diabetes. So bottom line, in this very good, very comprehensive, huge study, they are saying under 40, there's certainly no benefit to drinking and there's potential harm. But over 40, you get a little bit.
All right.
All right, this one leg standing test.
Yes. So it turns out that the ability to balance is not only a good predictor of how likely you are to fall, but how likely you are to live for long periods of time. So specifically, this was a test with 1,700 adults over the age of 50. And they simply said, stand on one leg for 10 seconds. For 10 seconds. And what they found is that a lot of people can't do that. 20% of people in this group were not able to stand on one leg for 10 seconds. And of course, as the age went up, the numbers got worse. And by age 70, only 50% of people could do it. Why do we care? Well, they followed these people for the next 7 years, and they found that those that could not stand on one leg for 10 seconds were 84% more likely to die.
Oh my God. Okay, wow. This is the most depressing story
I know.
Ever.
So when I was reading this, and that night I was out to dinner with a bunch of friends in a restaurant, and of course I reported this to the table, and we all immediately got up and stood on one leg. The problem was, is first of all, we'd already had our 2 glasses of wine for, you know, health. Mm-hmm. And I'd forgotten it was 10 seconds. I said it was 30 seconds. So we all failed miserably. We realized we were all going to die in the next 7 years, so we just drank more. So do it sober, and it's only 10 seconds.
Got it. All right. A new weight loss drug.
Yeah, you know, the mantra has always been that if you're having trouble losing weight and your doctor's like, okay, well, you just got to try harder, you got to eat less, you got to exercise more. But now weight loss experts are saying, no, there's this acknowledgement that even in people who do all the right things, some people just struggle because of genetics and biology. So they're really turning more to drugs to see what drugs can help these people get to a healthy weight. And there's been a number of new drugs that have been released, but there's one that just got FDA approved that the obesity world and the obesity medicine world is calling a game changer. And that's because the amount of weight people are losing is the same kinds of weight that you see with bariatric surgery. Mm. We're talking 30, 40, 50 pounds. The name of the drug is tirzepatide. It was out years ago as a diabetes drug, but they found that in higher doses, it is taking off huge amounts of weight. And this really is going to change the focus. Yes, you have to eat healthy. You need to be active. But if you're in that group that you're still not able to lose the weight, you may be a good candidate for a drug. And in fact, my most recent podcast episode, I interviewed Dr. Bob Kushner, who's one of the world's authorities in obesity medicine, and he talks about this drug and other drugs, and even more important, tells you how to find a doctor who will prescribe these drugs, because quite frankly, they're out there, we know they work well, we know they're safe, but not all doctors are going to be familiar with them.
Hmm. All right. Well, thank you. You can check out Dr. Streicher's podcast, the Menopause Podcast. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Time now for Around Town.
Hey, Anna.